And normally we open the time 11 o'clock, we open the phone lines, open the conversation as we interact with the fans on the outside, the listeners, wherever they might be in the vicinity, outside of the vicinity, but nevertheless in the vicinity of Choice Radio. And this morning, what is prompting, you know, the conversation is my mother. Yeah, my mother. You know, she grew up in the Anglican faith or Anglican church back in Grenada. And there are a lot of things that they do that is not scriptural, not in the scripture, not involved. And Jesus is not the main focus of all their worship. And she came and we spoke. She know I'm born again. She know I'm serving the Lord. And in all my enlightening and trying to enlighten her to the real gospel of Jesus Christ, what is in store, what is set up for her, what is there for us as believers who accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. And she listens. But after a while, it seems like she's still really back in the same way. Like she's just still comfortable with being how she was, you know. And so it kind of prompted me, because I mean, in my heart I'm kind of sad that, well, you know, she has not, you know, totally gone over or changed up and activated that new faith, that new thing. I know somebody understand what I'm talking about. So, you know, I love my mother, and my mother is a good woman. And nobody knows where, I mean, we don't know exactly, you know, where she's going to go, you know what I mean? But the Bible says, by the fruits you're going to know. And a lot of different things are evidence to what we believe, what we follow in. You know what I mean? So I'm just saying, I know that somebody out there in Radio Land might have experienced that or have that same kind of thing going on within their family. Somebody you love, somebody you look at a daily basis. And don't care how you try to bring Jesus to them. Don't care how you try to make them understand. How do you feel about it? How do you feel, especially like loved ones, people you're really close to, and you have accepted Christ and you would like to see them go on to glory? You would like to meet up with them in that place. If you make it all the way to the end, you would like to see some people on the other side with you. So that's the question this morning. How do you feel about loved ones, leaving loved ones behind? People that you love, you want to see them go on to glory. Let's go to the first caller. Hey caller, good morning. All right, caller, you there?
Good morning, yes, son. Good morning.
Good morning, brother Lowen. How you doing, sir?
I'm good, man. I'm good. You see, you always come with something. You know, from last time, I have this thing in my mind. You know, I'm married to a robot. I don't live with the wife again. And I say, there's a lot of people here, top of God, God is good, but they don't know. And I say, yes, I call it, one man say, call our brother-in-law and tell her about God. Yes, call her, but you know, I say, I call her Monday. And I say, what happened? And I say, call me and say, nothing about God. You have to tell we people, my brother Lee, living in Brooklyn Avenue, I want to call him and tell him about God to Sonny, my nephew. For God do so many good to brother Lou. I tell you, anyone come to Pastor Larry said tomorrow, you will hear brother Lou, I'm going to give some testimony about what God has done for brother Lou. The blow. You know, I did with 200 pounds, right? And now, when I check it...
Hold on, caller. Go ahead. Go ahead, caller. Caller, you there?
Hold on.
Only high blood pressure I have. I went to the hospital last week. They take my blood and I said, well, we can get my blood like that. Yeah, what did I say? Well, we have to take your blood. They said, what's wrong with you? I said, I didn't wear high blood pressure. Only high blood pressure. And they took it and said, yes, it's high blood pressure. I said, many times my head feels so dizzy. Satan is there. And I look on me and I said, Satan is there. And Satan will do anything, but in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Yes, you will conquer all. Yes, you are conquering and to conquer. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus.
And I want to tell Pastor Lali, hello, and we call. Are you called Mary? Hello, Pastor Lali.
All right.
And you will see me in church,
eh? Amen. Tomorrow.
Oh, yes, man. Glory to God.
Glory to God all the time, brother. Yes, brother. Thank you for the call.
Yeah, man. You will hear about family last more time again.
No problem.
The blow. Mm-hmm. I would like to see what that preacher man preached this morning. 6 o'clock. I love it, man.
All right, my brother.
Alright,
see you later. Thank you very much. God bless. Take care. Yes, we love you.
Not leaving you.
Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hey, caller. Good morning.
God bless you, beloved brother. How are you today?
I'm great in the name of Jesus. I'm standing strong on a rock.
Yes.
Amen. Which is Jesus. How are you doing?
Amen. I was hearing the question that you put out for this morning, wonderful question, and it causes, you know, you hear you talk about your mother, you love your mother dearly, and my brother, I believe everyone that put on the name of Jesus is worried about their families, but one thing I can encourage you to do is keep praying for her, that the revelation, because this is by revelation. The revelation of the gospel will be revealed to her. Because this is why so much problem is in the world today. Because obviously somebody didn't get the revelation. So we can see clearly, my brother, as I shared with you over the time I knew you. I myself was not in the truth all the time. My mother was a Church of God. Believe in Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And for years, she's been taking us to church. And some of my family were baptized in Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. But when the Lord revealed himself to me, I personally took it like a crusader to share what was revealed to me, to my family. And many says, my God, she's going off her rockers now. She's getting crazy because they have never heard me talk about Jesus the way I talk about Jesus. And lo and behold, one by one, you know what I did, my brother? I prayed for my family, and as often as I could drop in a word, because sometimes they don't allow you to drop in a word because they're in this thing so long, they are seasoned in what they are in. So it's only Almighty God and the Holy Spirit now can do that for you by praying to God and asking him to open the revelation to them. And let me tell you what happened to me personally. And this is why I am so anxious to share it on the radio. I remember 1 year when my mother took sick. And we were in the room with her. We were coming from school, my sisters and I. And my sister ran in the room first because we were hungry coming from school. And she said, hey, come, mama sick. And then I ran in the room, I saw my mother's eyes are rolling over. And by faith, I placed my hand on my mother. And I said, in the name of Jesus, I claim healing for my mother. And when my mother grabbed onto my hand and came back to me, she says, God heard you. And I said, wow. So my mother was taken to the hospital. and was diagnosed with high blood pressure, and she, whatever. But the, what I want to share with you this morning is, when my mother was in the hospital, I had a vision. Somebody came and showed me a fruit that could heal my mother. So I ran over to my elder sister's house and I said, I got this from my mother. She said, what are you talking about? I said, a lady in my vision showed me this and said, look after it and give it to your mother. It will cure your mother. So she said, listen, I don't understand these days you telling us you're getting this kind of thing. I said, my other sister said to me, Beth, let's go make this thing and give it to mom. So we went to the market, we got this stuff, came up, and I made this stuff for my brother, and I took it to the hospital. When I took it to the hospital, I said to my mom, I said, mom, I got this thing for you, you know, but I'm praying that nothing happened to you because my sister, they would kill me if anything worse happened to you. She said, I believe in visions and angels. She said she believed. So I gave her the thing, and she drank it, and you know what? The evening I left from work to go look for my mother, I didn't see her in the bed. The doctor said she got discharged, and he don't know what happened, but my mother got I was too. I was on a haste to get home. So when I got home, my mother called me, and she said, come here. She said, you're marked by God.
Hallelujah.
Being she drank, when the doctors came and took her pressure again, her pressure went back low. And for 20 years, my mother didn't have no more pressure. Hallelujah. Until I come in this country. And you know what my mother asked me one day when we went, she said, before I left here and come here, my mother said to me, what was the revelation you said you get about Jesus appearing to you and said, there's no God but him? And I told her again. And you know what? My mother went secretly to the church, to the church, and got baptized in Jesus' name. When I found out, I almost went, you know. I said, Mom, why you never tell me? One day, my brother was getting married in Mountain Bay, and my brother went to my church. You understand? So, whether they go by night or they go secretly, I don't care. The Lord, if you constantly pray, tell God, I don't want my family to be lost. God is going to do it for you. As you continue sincerely in this apostolic doctrine that you know is right, we can't argue it. Don't argue it with nobody because they won't see. You have to pray that God open their understanding. My last sister, she was in a Baptist church also. And for years, my sister believed in me, my brother. Everything she would call me to pray, everything she would seek me for advice, but she never would have come to the church and say, she admit. You know what happened? We went on the missions one year, and the Lord said, while I was fucking the Holy Spirit, say, bring 2 Bibles. And I said, God, why must you bring 2 Bibles? Anyway, I went out and got the Thompson Chain Bible, and I put a pack in the bag, not knowing who I'm going to give the Bible to. And you know what? When I land and finish missions, my sister, the one that followed me, she died and gone now, but thanks be to God, it is well with her soul. You know what she said to me, my brother? She said, Bev, you know, for years I've been pondering this thing about the Holy Spirit and how the Lord using you. And me know that the Lord using you, but me can't see it. Me say, this is not a natural eye business. I say, your heart has to open to the Lord, and you have to believe what you heard and read. Yes. I said, no. The Holy Spirit said, give her the Bible.
Hallelujah.
And my brother, I gave my sister that Bible. I said, in this is your first knowledge. Read this Bible and study it and see God and see something will happen. You know what happened? One day my sister called me. We were right somewhere enjoying ourselves. And she called me and said, Bev, I want you to come to my house, and I'm going to bring it to somebody who will just operate just like you. We said, there can't be nobody operate like me. It's just one of me God made. And we laugh it off, you know. I never know that this thing was so serious. She said, you can't go back to New York. You have to follow me. So I followed her the night and went to Mullines Road, her friend's house. And she said, look at this lady, Bev. And she said, tell the lady to look at me. She said, this lady, that I love my sister, so she said, you. She said, I bought a war with my sister have. So when my sister said that to my brother, it leaked into my heart. I said to her, Maggie, you really want what me have? She said, yes, I'm serious then, because this my friend here is operating the Holy Spirit on me here. On me, I pray, me can't feel no spirit, nothing. I said, Maggie, I call her name again because I was so serious, my brother. I said, you really want to experience the Holy Ghost? I said, you want to experience the Holy Ghost right now? She said, yes, right now. Now, in that lady's house, she said, my brother, there's a big living room, a marble living room, and if she had dropped on that, she would have died. And my friend said to me, he's baptized in Jesus' name, for the Holy Ghost. She said, Bev, we're going to agree tonight. I said, we're going to agree tonight. And the tears that have to follow my eye for my sister. She become as a, you ever lick a dog and see the dog just humble? That was how humble I saw my sister. For the first time, she has never humbled herself like that. And my brother, first we go for hole, and the Spirit said, no hole, no hand. Let us stand there. We stand in a little circle, three of us. And I said to my friend, I said, we're going to pray. I said, Maggie, tell God what you just tell me. Tell him you want to experience the Holy Spirit that he gives. Tell him. I said, we're going to pray, but you open your mouth by faith. It's by faith, Maggie. You got to believe it. And my brother, her friend, and I begin to pray. I mean, I prayed like there was no other day going up. And I said, God, my sister is so kind and good to people. I said, God, that not going to send her to heaven. Lord, let her experience you right now, God. Fill her with the Holy Ghost right now. And I mean, I heard our friend praying the same thing. And listen, it was like a whirlwind come down. It was like just bam, bam. And I saw my sister went down and prayed for Jesus. She never said Father. She never said Son. She never said Holy Ghost. She said Jesus. And the Holy Spirit took up hold of her that night. I mean, we never left that place until 1 o'clock in the night. And to make a dark night. And my brother, she had to drive us back home. And I had to be tapping her on her foot and her hand. I said, keep your eye open. When you reach home, this thing will finish. Let me tell you something, my brother. She never filled the Holy Ghost. So that anointing was an answer in Tamarind Lake. And I prayed and I came back to New York. One Sunday, we were sitting at my dinner table, my biggest eldest brother and I. And my sister had gone to Montego Bay to check on my brother's house. And coming back, somebody run her off the road. And her story that she told was, when the truck hit off our Jeep, and the Jeep was going over the gully, she said, Lord Jesus, don't let my son die in this truck with me. And she began to speak in tongues, she said. And the truck flipped over and landed on the wheel. And her son heard her speaking in tongues. And keep calling, Mama, you all right? Mama, you all right? She said when she came to, all she knew that somebody pushed on her. And she knew it was God who came and delivered her. Not a scratch on her son. And the Jeep was mashed up. She said she took out her phone, called for service, and when the police came, they dragged her out the gully, and the police drove her from where the truck went over the gully straight to her house in Kingston and landed at her gate, and she couldn't move the truck again. The truck was total off. And she told my brother, she says, I now believe the God that they've served, because she now have the Holy Ghost. So you know what, on our next trip, I took her to our mission place in St. Elizabeth, and we baptized her in Jesus' name. And my sister was never the same. So all you have to do this morning, and whoever is hearing my voice, keep praying for your loved one.
And every opportunity you get, you keep telling them about the Lord. They are watching your lifestyle, and they are watching what you're doing. But if the revelation don't come to them, it is not for you. It is not you who going to give them a revelation. It is God himself who is going to open their understanding. So keep praying, and God will do it. As he said, it is not his will that any should perish. But nobody can talk nobody into believing this thing. They have to receive it by revelation. So keep on trusting, and I know God is going to do it for your mother one day.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for the beautiful testimony indeed. I receive it in the name of Jesus.
Yes, my brother.
Thank
just
you, my sister.
And
God
keep,
bless. Yes.
You know, you tell him, keep it up, tempting you to get. You sit down with the word.
Amen.
But you can't knock her to believe it. You just have to timely say, Lord, open my mother understanding to this thing. Because listen, my brother, they were before us, right? And they're in this thing long time. And there were some places there's no apostolic church and they don't know. They have to stick to what they know. But at the same time, if they are sincere, because I've seen many people who come in and accept the truth. Many, many people. So God is not partial. You keep loving God and keep loving your mother and keep, you know, praying for her. And one day, bam, God gonna do it for you. Because he will answer your prayer. He will answer it. Because if he answer it for you to save you, he will answer it for somebody else. And I personally believe that the gospel, he said, must be preached in all the world for a witness. And then shall the end come. Because the gospel has power by itself, will do its job. And the word is power, is spirit, and is life. And there's nothing we can do to it but speak the word and let God be glorified. God bless you. And let us continue to preach the word of God and tell it wherever we go who Jesus is. Because everybody ought to know who Jesus is.
Hallelujah. Thank you, my sister, for the call. Indeed.
Bless you.
Amen. That's a strong one from Miss Beverly. 32 minutes on the other side of 11 o'clock. It's Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. And whatever we open and we put on the phone lines is just to edify us and to lift up the name of Jesus, that we who are believer and have come into the light, we like to strengthen each other, that we can be stronger in Christ, that he'll be glorified in every way. And the question we're asking this morning, how do you feel about leaving loved ones behind after you have tried to lead them to Christ and they didn't accept, especially if they have died? How do you feel about that? 347-663-8638. I was speaking to a young man and he said that many people are happy with the kind of religion that they are in because it gives them a sort of freedom. It's like you can go to the party tonight in the morning, you can come and confess your sins and all this kind of stuff. So 347-663-8638. If you're already in Radio Land and you have a comment, feel free to share with us. How do you feel about leaving loved ones behind after you've tried to lead them to Christ and they didn't accept, especially if they have died? How do you feel about it? 347-663-8638. If the question can be posed in a better way to maximize its potential for response, feel free. Paula, good morning.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Hello?
Yes, good morning. How are you doing?
Oh, good morning to you, sir.
Amen.
I heard your topic and I think it's very interesting. You know, I lost my dad on the 21st of October. And all my life knowing my dad, he wasn't a believer in the Lord. Although his wife was a Christian woman, is a Christian woman, and all the family are Christians, and we know God, and we believe in God. He was just set in his ways. But on the 21st of October, we know he was sick. So I was here, he's in Jamaica, I am here in New York, and I was in my kitchen, and my mind running in. And I called my mom, and I said, "Mom, I am concerned about my father's soul." So I said, "Mom, we need to pray the repentance prayer with him." So she said, "Okay, Suzette, you know, the family members are here, and we are going to pray the repentance prayer with him." So we had a chance to pray with him, and he accepted God as his Lord and Savior. And that night, about 9 o'clock or 9:20-something, he died. And when I heard that he died, I said to myself, "Oh, my God, you know, I just thank God that we had the opportunity to speak with him and to have him pray the repentance prayer." But today, I give a shout-out, and I employ all unsaved that not all of us are going to be lucky enough to be sick on our beds and get the chance to repent. A lot of us are going to be taken away in our sinful situation. So as you give the question, I'm saying it's a really, really good question this morning, because a lot of us as Christians, we have unsaved family members, and we are praying and we are hoping that, you know, they turn their life over to God. But as the lady said before, we just have to pray and leave it in God's hand. So my brother, just be encouraged. I hear you talking about your mom. Just be encouraged and continue to pray and allow the Lord to work it out.
Amen. Let me thank you for the contribution. And before you go, let me ask you a question. When you prayed with him, how was the sincerity level? What did you feel in your spirit about him?
Well, yeah, I really felt that he meant what he was saying, because he was quite humble. And I've never heard him this humble before. He was very humble, and he said, you know, yes, he accept the Lord, and he, you know, he know that he believed that Jesus died on the cross for his sin, and he confessed his sin, and he is ready to meet his maker. That was his comment. That's what he said to
us.
And I really felt it. You know, I said, "Oh my God, we thank God, you know, that he had that chance to really, you know, confess his sin."
So,
and then the night he passed.
Amen. Amen. I think it was on the right on time.
Yeah, it was really.
Yeah, I think the Holy Spirit prompted you to make the call on his behalf in that way, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And it's good that you were obedient.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Because one of the things that we have is that a lot of believers out there do not understand how to relate to the Holy Spirit. You know, he's the Spirit. And that's why we encourage people to take time out to spend with the Lord. You know, you can't keep your house in chaos and loud noise and music all the time and TV on, music on, everything on. As you know, as believers, we need to take time to just be with ourselves and be with our spirit and be with the Lord and take time and just let him talk into our spirit so we could know what next move to make. Because he's always talking to us, you know what I mean?
Yes, he is.
Amen. He is. Thank you, Sister Susie.
You're welcome.
God bless. All right. Indeed, how do you feel about leaving loved ones behind after you have tried your best to lead them to Christ and they didn't accept, especially if they have died? How do you feel? 347-663-8638. And we know how the world is nowadays. It's making you feel that there is no big deal in nothing, you know. There is no significance in being holy. It doesn't make a difference, you know. You can just put on your Halloween costume. Everybody's doing it, you know. But it's no big deal. Well, that is the trick of the enemy. Everything is a big deal in life. The Bible said in the last days, men's hearts are going to wax cold. Make sure your heart is not waxing cold this morning on the Lord and his opportunity. Caller, good morning to you. Caller, good
Hello?
Morning. Hey, good morning.
Good morning. I'm listening to your program for the very first time.
Glory to God.
God, right. Listen, I am 55. And it take me a long time to find Christ. But you have to just know your mommy keep praying and doing everything. I was so hard that don't care the sign God showed me, I couldn't understand. And the thing, when God says, I'm not letting you go this time, he make me became homeless. He stuck me in Jamaica for 4 months. 4 months. People that know me, I mean, I became homeless. I live in the United States from 1979. And every time God show me a sign and show me a sign and give me a chance and give me a chance. And when God mean this time, you're not getting away. He stuck me in Jamaica for 4 months. I became homeless, penniless, familyless, everything less. And my mother sent me some money and I went to go to this big funeral. This is when I'm homeless. And when I went and I look on the shoes, and the lady says to me, she's not changing the U.S. today because she have a bill to pay and she have to pay in Jamaica and she don't want to buy in the U.S. and then it runs short. I went to a next lady, Anne-Marie Duncan, and when I went to her to change the U.S. to go back and buy the shoes, she said to me, oh, you buy U.S. and you sell U.S. and you got a foreign. I said, Annie, you know, you say, I lost my the judge of the passport. She said, you where you do? Go on for your clothes and come go to church with me. I'm on it. She could have buy the U.S., you know. She could have buy the U.S., but God assured me, said, no, you not get away again. You see, when I go home the night, and we go to church the Sunday morning, when I reach in a church, I know this is it now. When I reach in a church, I see so much people that used to buy from me, customer. And when I reach a church, I said to Annie, you know, so I baptized. She said, but I was a foolishness. Come, God, just come in dry church. And when I leave church over, I sit out in the yard. And a man named Managat come to me. And him said, you stop, Annie. Yeah, but yeah, one thing I know, you're hard for dead. Why every time you cheat dead, my car stick by my grave by the last time I was sick. I was in a coma for 5 weeks.
Hallelujah,
and
Jesus.
Walk away from the coma and still never baptized. You understand?
I hear you.
Didn't do nothing for God. And when I went and the man of God come and talk to me and just talk, like as somebody know me say, I want to baptize. Anyhow, we went to this place the night. He was invited at this church. And I didn't have nothing better for God. And I said to Annie, I'm coming with her. And she said, come. And when we went up there, it was a baptism. I said, I want to baptize. Him says, no, you're not going to baptize like this. Give yourself a chance to see it. I say, I want to baptize. Anyhow, they've never baptized me. Tuesday. This is now, I get a place to lay my head now, you know. He give me a house with family and nieces and nephews. He give me a whole family now. Because Anne-Marie Duncan's house became mine because she give me a room to sleep in. When we go fasting the Tuesday, because now everything is just church, because I go in a house where everything they speak God. If you take a spoon of water to your mouth, you have to say thank you before you put that spoon, because her house is like this. All right. When we go fasting Tuesday, I want baptized. Because I was so many times take the classes, everything. I understand everything, but I never baptized. This is Sunday, the Tuesday, when I go to church, the man of God says to me, you see, when you go to town, it's going to be judgment, pantapa judgment. Only thing you must do, keep remembering, the Lord is my shepherd. don't open your mouth and speak to anybody, because all judgment going to come down on you. When the crowd come and the fight and they want to chop me up, I mean, this girl went for a loss and get a woman to chop me and the woman couldn't take the loss. All I says to her, marvel what me and you have. And the woman muscle up and give me one pitch in my stomach. My break, my fall with the hand, and my hand break. You see, when Wednesday morning, before they, when I go, and they call him, and him come, I, the man just looked at me and said, what did I say to you in church? Don't say anything. Why did you open your mouth? You have to listen to God. I says the man of God, I want baptized. Sunday when I went to church, they didn't want baptize me. I said, no, I'm going to baptize. Nobody going to stop me. And when I baptized the Sunday, that was the best thing I do. For the last 4 months is the best time I have. And you see, when God will help you, he might help you. My business is closed in Jamaica now. And when I went to Jamaica 2 weeks ago, I said, Lord, I need you to help me get $50,000 so I could pay it. And you know, I find a purse in at the airport with $517. I swear, when I go to Jamaica, I could pay my $50,000 and stop them from auction off my goods. The container is still locked. But hallelujah. Listen to me. Anything God put on for you, you are going to get it. And me, Cecile Bryan, I tell you, say, when me find that $517, the 17th of this last month gone, in a Norman, in a Kennedy airport, only God can watch you. Everybody pass the purse, and I me find it. God is a good God. Keep praying for your mother. It's the first I'm listening to Choice Radio, because now I'm a God, so I'm listening to this program. Praying for your mother. Pray for her. Pray and talk to God. He will answer you, because him answer me.
Hallelujah.
Him answer me, Cecile, yes. Brian.
Hello. Hallelujah.
And listen, gunman hold me up, the gun stick. Can I turn over with me? People will know me with Carly and say it's true. Can I turn over with me and me come through the window and never have a scratch? Me know what a lady there talk about. I fall in a coma for 5 weeks at University Hospital. And when I come out, I was businessless, everythingless, and in $3.5 million debt in Jamaican money. And God met my Peter for me. Still couldn't give my life to him till he met me homeless. I mean, Judge Fusey have the passport and I have the green card. You understand?
Yes,
but
yes.
Him chased me enough, and when God has chased you, it means you have to stop. So people who are listening to this program, when I say sign and wonder, stop and say, Lord, I surrender all. And like that lady said, once you do that prayer of faith and hope and do that prayer and say, Lord, I surrender. Don't go back. Just surrender. Keep praying for your mother in Jesus' name. And this is my testimony. My casket by, my graveside by, and I used to joke and say the reason why I never died is because it by at Medaris and all my friends died buried at Dovecot, and it was a far walk. Believe me, Cecile Bryan, when I'm saying to you, pray for your mother and pray sincere and keep talking to her and counselor. My mother is a pastor. My mother couldn't get me to baptize for nothing and surrender, and know that I surrender all. I don't look for manual. Meet after out there night time with the NSA, with the Beanie Man, the Vice Cartel. These are my friends. These are the people, the angel, the bounty, and the baga baga, and the hyping. They used to call me Mother Hype, because I would have out there with the range and the this. You can't imagine you're going to dance and you're not drink, and when you look at your agong, you have over $50,000 worth of liquor agong, and you're not drink.
Hallelujah.
Just the whole of hype.
Hallelujah.
And God take it all. And left me homeless, because when I went to Jamaica to go to court, I never know the judge go and take the passport, but it means that you're not get ready this time. And when him come for your mother, she has to go down. She has to go under that bloody water there and come up back clean and white as snow. Because when me come up back, you're light like feather, your things are mad. Tell you, since me surrender to God, everything around me just a pick off and be clean. Pray for mommy and listeners. Trust me, these are the woman will do it all. That's why I know me come over to that side and me not miss nothing. Me fly go England with stone up for anniversary. Go dance. Okay?
Hallelujah.
Keep praying.
Thank you, mommy.
Keep
Thank you for your call in Jesus'
name.
Hallelujah.
And listener, believe when God come, you have to answer. Because I'm not let you go when him needs you. Because him say him chase the one that him love. Him go and chase your mother in your eyesight. Makes you have to go to church and sit down with you and say, Jesus, I says to you in Jesus' name, I surrender all. And this is my living testimony from Cecile Bryan. Thank
Amen.
You.
Thank you
but
in Jesus'
let
name.
Let me have a chance to testify to you this morning.
In
Thank
Jesus'
you.
Name. Thank you very much.
In
indeed.
Jesus' name.
Wow. Thank you, Mr. Cecile Bryan. 9 more minutes before the 12, if you're all day in Radio Land and you heard this testimony. It's as real as it gets. God is real. Calling you to repentance this morning. We're going to take a few more calls if you're all day in Radio Land. How do you feel about leaving loved ones behind after you've tried to lead them to Christ and they didn't accept? Especially if they have died now. How do you feel about leaving the ones that you love after preaching to them time and time again? 347-663-8638. Once again, Ms. Brian, we thank you for your serious contribution to the topic this morning. Souls have been touched and blessed. 347-663-8638. If you're out there in Radio Land, you have a testimony or you have a word of advice. 347-663-8638. As we encourage you, do not harden your heart. Do not harden your heart to God and His calling. He wishes for none to perish, not one. All should come into the abundance of life. 347-663-8638. What a testimony. What a testimony this morning. 347-663-8638. Those on the phone lines, 213-493-0146. If you want to listen on the phone, you can get the radio. 213-493-0146. Write it down. Just dial that number on your phone. 213-493-0146. Or you can download TuneIn Radio app on your phones, iPhone or the Android, whatever you have. Go to the store and download TuneIn Radio, T-U-N-E-I-N, TuneIn Radio. After you download the app, you look for D-Choice Radio. Listen with good quality. You can plug it into your stereo. 347-663-8638. How do you feel about leaving loved ones behind, people you care about, sisters, brothers, and you've been trying to give them the gospel? You try your best to get them to line up with Jesus Christ and they have not accepted Him to this date. How do you feel? No one knows the hour. when that number is gonna come straight, not boxed. 347-663-8638. Shy, don't be intimidated. 347-663-8638. If you're out in Radio Land, you have a testimony. Let's glorify the name of Jesus. He's worthy. I'm telling you, man. One thing, believers, we have to make sure we never forget our testimony. Never make the devil forget where you came from. Let him know that you know where you came from and you're not going back. Glory to the Almighty God. 347-663-8638. I'm gonna take one or two more calls if you're out there. Don't be intimidated. Be proud. We were proud when we were in the devil kingdom. Have done anything. Now we're in Christ. Let's do all for the Lord, for His glory and His honor. He is worthy in the name of Jesus. He is worthy. 347-663-8638. Got a few moments left in the segment. A few minutes left before we shut down the phone line. So if you're out there. How do you feel about loved ones? Leaving loved ones behind? Those who have not accepted the Lord. Especially if they have died. How do you feel about your loved ones that have gone on without accepting the Lord? As we get ready to shut down the phone lines, we thank all those who participated this morning. Thank all those who were brave enough to share what they had. And most of all, we thank you for listening, you know what I mean? You didn't have something to share, but you just was a diligent listener, taking notes. What would we do without the listeners? That's why we're here, so you can listen to the gospel of Jesus Christ and Him crucified. What an awesome gesture. Someone dying to save you. Wow. Good morning. Caller, good morning.
Hello, good morning, Brother Dolo.
How are you doing, sir?
Very well, thanks. Well, I'm not answering the question directly, but I just want to make a suggestion in relation to the question concerning loved ones. Well, obviously, yeah, I can answer the question. When a loved one refuses Jesus, of course, that's of great concern to you, and if they die, then it breaks your heart because you know you're not going to see them again if you're saved. But concerning, while they're alive now, and you as a born-again Christian try to reach them with the gospel, and probably you made many attempts prayerfully and all of that, and they resist, I personally would want to suggest that you secretly assign somebody who you know, you know, is walking with the Lord and they can share the gospel with them, and somebody that they most likely will listen to, you assign such a person to that relative. I did that already with my my grandmother, for example. She was religious, but not saved, and she couldn't see well where she's a lost sinner. The question she would ask is, what wrong am I doing? Look at how I live here and stuff. And you're trying to tell her, well, you know, Jesus saves and you must repent of sin. It's not the religious things that you follow, the customs, the traditions. And she just can't see it. But then I sent, I stayed up here one time and the burden came upon me for her. And I called my former pastor in Grenada, whom I have a good relationship with, and told him, please go to the place where I used to live and visit my grandmother and reach her with the gospel, because I used to witness to her and she refused, but I just have this concern. And so he went, you see, good pastor. He went and shared the gospel with her and showed her the way to Christ. And you know what happened? She received Jesus Christ as her Savior that day.
Wow.
It wasn't very, very long after that. Probably six months to a year. Then she fell sick and then she died. You see? So I'm suggesting that don't try to go it alone, because sometimes your relatives take you for granted. Oh well, I know you just born the last time, look, I bring you in the world or whatever, you know. And they think that they don't have to listen to you. Probably you have to listen to them instead. So, but you assign somebody else, you know, another Christian who is walking with the Lord and stuff and who is effective.
Yeah. So, in other words, you're saying, adding to the prayer that you are praying that God is going to deliver them, you also get in motion some different plans, some strategies.
Right, strategy, right. So you sit down and you strategize. You say, look, I'm going to send, I know this sister who lives there. She's about her companion, she's saved. Or he, or whatever, and I'm gonna, or somebody younger, or somebody that she respect, who is saved, you know, and you send them to the person. And I'll give you another example. There was one lady who she was the mother of a pastor's wife, right? And they lived in the same house. The pastor was living there, and his wife living there, and his family, and then she's there, but she was not saved. And no matter how they witnessed to her, she don't want to receive the Savior Jesus at all. So one day I sat home, that's a few years ago, very well, and I felt the burden, and I went to the house. It's people I knew. So I went to the house, and I went with the purpose of visiting her, because she was sick, but she had all the faculties, she wasn't that bad. And I shared the gospel with her. I stayed in the room, I witnessed, I quote the scriptures, and I tell her the situation, you know, her lost condition. If she dies, she would not see Jesus. She would go to hell. I tell her the truth. And prayerfully witnessed her. And her daughter was sitting right there on the floor. And you know what? That day, she nodded and said yes. She wants to receive Christ. And we led her to Christ that day. I tell you, that was a glorious day. And it wasn't too long after that, she got worse. You know, probably a few months running now. Not long, maybe 2 months or so. And then she died. And that was the testimony, you know, that she received Jesus Christ and everybody was happy. So sometimes it's not somebody in your own family. Probably not you, but somebody else, right? But you got to stand and pray and ask God to show you who you can assign to this person, this relative, or even close friend, whatever, loved one.
Amen. So,
do the work.
Let me say this to you also. I've realized that a lot of people are comfortable in their state of Christianity, in the sense that they go to church, or they're doing certain things that their grandparents were doing, whatever, and to them they feel that they're already saved. They don't need nothing else, if you understand what I'm saying. They feel that, well, what you're saying is not really different from what I'm doing. I'm going to church and I'm whatever it is, although they are not baptized, they have not accepted Jesus Christ the way we're talking about. And what we come to realize is that some people probably are just comfortable knowing that with the religion or whatever it is that they are associated with, they are able to go to party and next day they go to confess their sins. So they feel they want to live that double life, and that which they are following is giving them that avenue that they can do or indulge in both things. So they think they they feel that what I'm doing is good. I'm already saved that way, and this has been working for me because I could live how I want and then just go and, you know, confess my sin in a little box, and then I think I'm good to go. What do you say about that?
Well, you know, and that's a very old problem, because one of the most difficult time Jesus had on the earth with people was with or the type of people that he had the most problem with was religious people. So they thought that they were okay, they were all right. Well, what he's talking about, but then they didn't understand the new message, the gospel. So now these people are in the religiosity, and it's very difficult to find to let a religious person see his or her lost condition, because they're convinced that what they're in is really right. Very difficult. But I believe in situations like that, it's not a one-shot deal, and it's not you have to be so careful, because you don't want to lose the connection with them. So you got to take it nice and slow with them and show them from the Bible. When you establish that the Word of God is what you got to follow, if you could ever establish that with them, then you're well on your way to making progress with them. If you can't, or if you didn't, then I think the task is very difficult, because they're going to have all the other religious traditions that they follow and all the falsehood that they believe. That would be still, you know, dominating the mind and conviction. So I say, establishing with them that the Word of God is the authority. And if they say, yes, I believe that, then you say, all right, let's open this book and see here now what the Word of God has to say about the salvation of the human soul. And you take it from there, and I tell you, you could make some progress with that. But very difficult to find somebody who is religious lost, to make them see that they are lost and they're going to hell, because they think they're going to heaven. But, you know, come back to the point. You show them, hey, the Word of God is the basis for determining truth. And once you bring them around to that, you have them going. You know, they'll be under conviction, I believe. Yeah.
If they are willing not to lean to their own understanding.
Well, of course.
Amen, of indeed, course. Indeed. Yeah. So let me thank you for the contribution, my brother.
All right.
In the name of Jesus, as we shut down the phone line. All right, we thank that last caller right there, Brother G. 7 minutes on the other side of the 12, indeed. If you found the Lord and you're free in Christ, bask in your freedom today. Bask in it. Remember where you was and all the useless things you have done in your life, all the money you wasted, all the life you have wasted, and now you are free in Jesus. Hallelujah.
A blessing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free.
I am free. Praise the Lord. I am free. Bound, no more chains holding me. My soul is resting. It's just a blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I am free. Praise the Lord. I am free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul is resting. is just a blessing. Praise the Lord, hallelujah, I'm free. Yeah. Free, I'm free, I'm no longer bound. Praise the Lord, I'm free. I'm free, Lord, I'm so glad I'm free. Thank God Almighty, I'm free.
Free at last.
I'm free at last.
Free at last.
I wanna tell the world I'm free.
Praise the Lord.
I wanna praise the Lord. I'm free at last.
Free at last.
Oh, I'm free at last.
Free at last.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Oh God, I'm free.
I'm free. Free at last.
I'm no longer bound.
Free at last.
I want to tell the world.
Of angels and have no charity, the heart is empty, even though I feed the poor, the heart's still not pure. But when Jesus shines in, the man gets sweeter, the heart is changed, and the deeds reflect the Creator. Foolish heart, the Lord, he's knocking at your door.
Let him come in
to change your life. He has the power to do it for sure. A brand new life, he wants to give. Eternal life is yours to live. Oh, foolish heart,
foolish heart.
The Lord is knocking at your door.
I speak with the tongues of men and have no charity. The heart is empty. Oh, foolish heart, even though I bestow all my gifts to feed the poor, the heart's still not pure. But when Jesus shines in, the man gets sweeter.
Foolish heart, he gave his life for you. Whatever you need, just ask and you will receive. Ask for love change your heart. Your brother's keeper, you'll ne'er depart. Oh, foolish heart, the Lord is knocking.
So we're talking about the heart.
Your door.
It is not you, it's about the heart. We get into the heart this morning.
Though I speak,
thank you, Jesus,
with tongues of angels and have not charity.
Don't care what difficulty you're going through. As you accepted Christ,
the heart is empty.
Still be joyful. Find a way to be joyful. That you're no longer where you were.
And though
something you gotta know,
the poor, the heart,
nobody can tell it to you.
Pure.
You're the only one who know your life. You know where you came from.
Jesus,
this is one great pleasure to be no longer bound by the world.
Sweeter.
And all the chaos. You're no longer bounded by it.
Uh-huh.
You're no longer attached.
Hey.
You're no longer a friend of all this chaos. We got to appreciate that indeed. Those who are born again, let's keep appreciating
but when
where we have came from. 60 minutes on the other side of the 12. It's Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice.
And get sweeter.
Hope you're striving to make yourself feel good today. Is that what life is about? You got a part to play. You play your part. We're going to play our part right here. You put a joy in your soul this morning.
And the deeds reflect.
Don't forget 1 o'clock, Witch Country, Bada. We're going to serenade you until about half an hour point. And at 12:30, we're going to change the pace and get you in the right frame of mind to call and big up your country at 1 o'clock. And if you're a first-time listener, every 1 o'clock we open the phone line, we do something called Witch Country, Bada. Which country can get the most phone calls in on behalf of their country? And we're just testing your patriotism and your patience. The phone is going to be very busy, but that's when we check your patience. So that's 1 o'clock. Which country, Bada?
Sitting by the road corner. said, look at life, it is unfair, and don't you think that I should change? I'm wandering about the streets all day, can't even find a resting place. If you think that it's time that you should try, make that major change. Time for you to let Jesus make that change, to let you go, cause you've been going up and down in this world, and you don't know where to go. For you to let Jesus make that change, to let you go, cause you've been going up and down in this world, and you don't know where to go. To let you go, cause you've been going up and down in this world, and you don't know where to go. You don't know where to go.
I tell you, there's a sweet spirit in the studio, man. I'm telling you, I wish you could experience it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I don't care what I feel like, man. Once I start lifting up the name of Jesus, man, he just lets you know, I'm listening, I'm paying attention, I'm checking you out. So I encourage you, man, don't care what you're feeling at home, just lift up the name of Jesus. Just keep glorifying him and he'll let you know that I'm with you. You gotta strive. Yes.
When I wake up in the morning, I lift my eyes to you. When I hear you calling,
double play from the Jalin family, indeed. 23 minutes on the other side of the 12 o'clock. And I'll tell you which country battle last week was Grenada. With a very strong run, 37 points. Followed by a strong run from Guyana with 27 points. Followed by Jamaica in third position with 24. Followed by St. Lucia with 23. 16 for Panama, 11 Trinidad. 8 points for St. Vincent. The week before that, this was Jamaica. 1 point over Grenada. 39 points for Jamaica, 39 Grenada. 21 Guyana, 19 Panama. 8 for Trinidad. Let's go back one more week. Week before that, it was Guyana. All the way in the top with 34 points over Grenada. Did I say Grenada? No, not Grenada yet. Guyana 34 points in the second position, 32 points for Panama. Third position Grenada with 26 points. Fourth position Trinidad with 24 points over Jamaica with only 12 points, followed by St. Lucia with 11 points. Let's go one more week back. It was Grenada with a big one, 56 points, followed by a tie between Panama and Guyana, 27 points each. Trinidad 19 points, St. Lucia 12, Jamaica 7. Wow, let's go back again. Let's go back one more page again. Another week again in the top position. St. Lucia with 33 points. Wow. Yeah, St. Lucia 33 points, followed by Grenada with 30 points. followed by Panama with 28 points, followed by Guyana with 33. 13 for Trinidad, but before Trinidad, 18 for Jamaica. Let's go back one more week. Let's go back one more week. One more Saturday again. Let's go back a little further in the archives. Mm-hmm. All right. There we go. Jamaica with 44 points. What a devastating beaten. 44 points. Second position, 29 points, Grenada. Followed by Trinidad, 25 points. 24, Guyana. 8, Haiti. 2, St. Lucia. Wow. Should I go back one more? Okay, I'm going to work one more page. One more page, one more week. 39, Jamaica. 23. Before I say Grenada, I say 24 for Trinidad in the second position that week. Followed by 23 for Grenada. 9 for Guyana, 9 for Haiti, a tie. A tie between Belize and Panama with 4 points. So at 1 o'clock today, we do it all over again. I hope you're in a good mood this morning, man. I'm telling you, you gotta rise up your soul. If you don't, the enemy is gonna have a field day with you. He's gonna devour you. If you fall and you allow the negative to override the positive that's already been said in your life, you're gonna have a problem. So you better rise up your soul and know who you are in Christ. Remember, the thief come to steal and destroy. He came to give us life.
When I wake up in the morning, I lift my eyes to you. When I hear you calling, I know your voice is true. I go down on my knees and pray to thank the Lord for this day, to bring me closer and to let me know you. For you are the Creator and my deliverer. I just wanna praise you. I just wanna love you. I just wanna praise you. I just wanna love you. Shine upon me, Father. Let your love show within me. I wanna be the guiding light that shine through the darkness. I wanna be the shining star that shows the way to your righteousness. So let me shine and let me climb. Let me tell the world that you are mine. Oh, I just wanna praise you. I just wanna love you. Oh, I just wanna praise you. I just wanna love you.
Oh, 29 minutes past the 12.
I just wanna praise you.
Rise up your soul. Rise up your soul this Saturday, man. Don't care what the world is telling you. Oh, know that you are a new creature in Christ. What more you need?
Choice Radio. Here we go. Here we go. Want inspiration, want to be lifted and refreshed. You gotta turn your radio.
Choice Radio, Choice Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on listening.
friend.
Bruce's Patties, Bruce's Patties. It's all about the original Bruce's Patties and Baked Things, located at 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and East 96th Street in Brooklyn. Telephone 718-922-CAKE, that's 718-922-2253. All baking is done on premises, or you're longing to eat some real delicious patties. Check out the original Bruce's Patties and Baked Things. They have the best patties in Brooklyn. Oh my God, they have beef, chicken, veggie, salmon, fish, and of course, Aki Patties right here in Brooklyn. Also, are you celebrating an event? Do you need a cake? The original Bruce's Patties have the best birthday cake in Brooklyn. Wedding cake, karate cake, red velvet cake, and your photo cake. Ask about their pastries, their plantain tart, their currant rolls, the coconut drop, hotter bread, whole wheat bread, and their trini bread. That's the original Bruce's Patties and Baked Things. 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and East 96th Street in Brooklyn. Telephone 718-922-CAKE or 718-922-2253. 253. Desmond is back.
Connect to Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com or listen on your phone by dialing 213-493-0146. You can also download the TuneIn Radio app on your cell phone. And look for the Choice Radio and enjoy the sounds of praises.
Take care of your body. If you don't take care of yourself, who will take care of you? So get Dr. Robert Brand Blood and Body Bitters. Dr. Robert's Red Blood Tonic fights off fat, cholesterol, itchy skin, and it nourishes the body to improve blood circulation. Livergin and Bynum-Amara contributes to keep the liver and blood healthy from toxin and the effects of diabetic and blood pressure medicines. Get Nervogen Tonic Powder, which helps to strengthen the nerves, brains, muscles, and even fosters better sleep. Dr. Robert's Diabetic Tonic helps to reduce blood sugar. Dr. Robert's Brand Flaxseed Oil Capsules and Cordyceps contributes to healthy skin, healthier hair, body, face, and even provides a younger look and reduces cholesterol. Get Trout Hall brand Carrot Nectar and Mama Haiti brand Mango Nectar, full with more fruits and fibers than the other watered-down brands. Demand Dr. Robert's high-quality teas and products in order to enjoy great quality and save at the same time. Always purchase Tip Top Circle Cheese. Yes, Tip Top Circle Cheese makes 8 delicious sandwiches. Just add a little mustard and hot sauce in the Tip Top Cheese. On sale now in most West Indian food stores and supermarkets. Or by wholesale through AFN Brokers 908-486-0077 or IMP Food at 25 Brooklyn Terminal Market.
If Choice Radio is a blessing and an inspiration to you, write us at Choice Gospel Network, P.O. Box 30016, Brooklyn, New York 11203. Connect to Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com or listen on your phone by dialing 213-493-0146. You can also download the TuneIn Radio app on your cell phone and look for the Choice Radio and enjoy the sounds of praises.
All right, as we get back inside, taking you up to the 1 o'clock, which country bada? Can your country get the most phone calls inside? Can you make your country win today by having the most patience to call the number 347-663-8638 at 1 o'clock? Write it down. 347-663-8638, 1 o'clock, call as much as you can. And when you get on, just say Jamaica, Grenada, St. Lucia, Panama, Haiti, Barbados, Guyana, where are you from? At 1 o'clock, just call and shout your country. Remember, no slogans. Don't say JA, don't say Spice Isle, don't say Vince, don't say GT. Call your country by its name at 1 o'clock, all right? Also, the month of November is dedicated to the kids, to the young people 15 years and under. for the Psalms reading on Sunday, all right? So Psalms reading on Sunday, November month, will be dedicated to the young ones to give them a chance to get on. In December, we're looking to put on a read-off. Yeah, a read-off. The adults category and the young ones category. So 15 years and under will be the partakers of the young people segment. So from this Sunday, tomorrow, God's willing, we'll be only listening to 15 years and under. All right, so get the young ones from your church to call and be a part of it. And at the end of it all, we are going to choose winners in the young people category and in the adult category. All right, so 15 years and under, get ready for Psalms reading tomorrow between 5 and 6 o'clock right here on Choice Radio. All right.
I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness, I'm trading my pain, the joy of the Lord. We say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
Come on, dance around in your living room, man. Dance around in your house. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Come on, man. Morning to the Jalim family, Super 8 and the family. Dance around, man. Psych up yourself. How you think this thing work? I heard a young man say he accepted Christ and he don't see nothing happen. What do you think? Somebody gonna come and put on new shoes in your foot and put on new clothes on your back? What do you think? You have to activate this, man. This is by faith. Faith. That's the difference between the old and the new covenant. Back in the days, everything was physical. Physical application, a physical priest. Physical sacrifices. No, just the heart connection. It's like back in the days, you gotta make a call. You have the phone call going from the line to the receiver, to the box on the wall, to the pole outside your house, down the street to your neighbor next door, and back into the house, and you can physically see the connection. Now you can just pick up your cell phone, look at the keypad and touch. Boop, 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 boop. Hello, mommy, what's going on? All the way across the world. That's the same thing, baby. The New Testament. Faith through Jesus Christ. Yes. Activate your faith this morning.
I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame.
Miss Morrison, good morning.
Laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Activate your new life this morning.
Sickness, I'm trading my pain, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. We say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. But not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for his promise will endure, that his joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, his joy comes with the morning. Joy of the Lord.
Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. I am pressed but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will endure, that His joy's gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, His joy comes with the morning, yeah. I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Make a full trade in. Hey, 1241. If you're on the job, good afternoon. Hope you're in a good mood, baby. We just want to lift up your spirit. Yes, indeed. As we go for it, 1 o'clock. Waterloo. This one is for you. Hey, Tanti, good morning.
For the Lord is my shepherd.
Hey, Miss Morrison.
Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com.
Get your phone charge up. Which country, Bada? 1 o'clock. I don't care where you're from, participate. If you're a child of God. Brother Clarence, good morning to you, man.
Names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Get ready for 1 o'clock. Which country, Bada?
Subject unto us. And blessed adapted unto our.
Who can get the most phone calls on behalf of the country? 347-663-8638.
Jesus' name is a strong tower. In Him there is a mighty hill.
You gotta rejoice in Jesus, man. No other way. This thing cannot be done no other way.
We rejoice in
You gotta do it.
Names are written in the
Or else it cannot be done.
Clever subjects.
Hey, Gary, good Jamaica.
Seductive under our feet in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name is a strong tower. In him there is a mighty healing. Like the mighty warrior, the darkness is under his feet. He'll become the conqueror. I must remain his warrior. For the darkness is under my feet.
Ooh, yeah.
For the darkness is under. Rejoicing God that all
you gotta know it's under your feet, baby.
Life.
Nobody can do it for you but you for yourself.
I'm blessed with adapted under our feet in the name of Jesus.
Is it under your feet this morning? Are you sure? You sure?
Jesus' name is a strong tower. In him there is a mighty healing. Like the mighty warrior, the darkness is under his feet. He'll become the conqueror. I must remain his warrior. For the darkness is under my feet. What a darkness is under my feet. What a darkness is under my feet. What a darkness is under my feet.
St. Louis, good morning, afternoon, morning, whatever it is.
La 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 la.
All the deacons.
La la la. La la la.
Yes.
La la.
1 o'clock, which country, Bada?
La 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 la. What is happening?
Can Guyana go all the way today? Can Grenada do it again?
Darkness.
Can Jamaica come back on top?
Peace.
Can Trinidad rise?
Darkness.
Can St. Vincent do it again? Is it possible for St. Lucia?
Darkness under my feet.
Where is Barbados? Can Dominica rise? Where is Haiti? Where is Belize?
The devil is the darkness, I've been
to the Virgin Islands.
Under my feet is where
wherever you're from.
You can't do me any harm. God Almighty is holding my hand. For the darkness, under my feet.
Under my feet.
For the darkness,
under my feet.
For the darkness,
claim it's under your feet, man.
Feet.
That's the way it work.
For the darkness. Under my feet.
La, well, Atwell, good morning to you.
La la la.
Pastor Vincent.
La 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 la. 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 For the darkness.
Sister Maggie.
Under my feet.
Foot number 13.
For the darkness. Under my feet.
Is it there?
For the darkness.
Do you see it?
Under my feet.
Are you trampling right now?
Oh, hallelujah. Hold your hands here, come on, blow for 10. Are you ready tonight? Can I hear you scream?
Joyous celebration.
Joyous celebration.
Joyous celebration.
Joyous.
And in this family,
we hear
Hamilton.
Are you ready tonight? Blow for 10.
Oh.
Come on, put those hands together.
Oh,
hallelujah, I saw the very big God.
Oh, hallelujah,
are you ready tonight?
Do
it. Oh, hallelujah, I saw the very big God.
Oh,
listen, my God, you be big.
Oh,
my God, you find.
Oh,
My God, you're kind, oh. My God, you're too much, yeah. Let me do it again. My God, you're big, oh. My God, you're fine, oh. My God, you're kind, oh. My God, you're too much, oh. Listen, listen. When I look to my right, when I look to my front, when I go to my phone, when I go to my back, come on. When I go to my right, when I go to my left, when I go to my front, hey. When I go to my back, say. When I go to my right, when I go to my left, when I go to my front, when I go to my right. Let me hear you scream. Oh, hallelujah! I serve a very big God.
Oh, hallelujah!
Oh my God. I serve a very big God, oh.
Oh,
hey!
All right.
Oh, hallelujah. I get go find an eye.
Don't care what the enemy telling you. Start a praise this morning. It's something you gotta do, man.
Goodness and mercy shall follow me all of the days.
Gado family, good morning. Still best of family. She's the Fleming, all the crew.
Si ponche maula mi.
Which country, bada?
Me
8 more minutes away. Get your phone ready, get your phone ready. We'll get the most calls in. And have the most patience on the lines.
Thank you.
We'll be vindicated.
Thank you.
Forget, give him thanks.
Yeah.
Don't get what that liar try to tell you.
Never
in your finance, in your physical, wherever.
No.
Don't forget to give him thanks. He's worthy.
Oh,
he came to give life. Dante. Hey, Fox and the family, good morning. Thank you for your strength, Jesus. Thank you for your strength. If you didn't give me strength, how would I be able to sustain? Thank you, Jesus. It's a lonely walk. Worth every minute of it. Hold on to God's unchanging hand if you're a believer. Your phone ready for 1 o'clock. Who got the fastest fingers? Who got the best phones in America? Who got the best phone connections? And who can use it right? We're gonna find out at the top of the hour. Which country, bada? Remember, no slogans. Call your country by its name.
Well, if I fail to remember to give you thanks, my God.
forgive me.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Lord, I'm sorry.
Never forget.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. May I never.
Don't be ungrateful.
To try my best to say thank you, Lord. Oh. And be my best to remember to give you thanks, my God.
Mm.
Please forgive me.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Lord, I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. May I never forget to try my best to say thank you, Lord.
Mrs. Jesus.
Family, I got you.
Oh, sounds one tree. Say
oh. 4 more minutes to the top, Eddie Neblett.
Oh, I'm feeling a river flowing out of my innermost being. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling a river flowing out of my innermost being. I'm feeling it. Come say it one more time with me. I'm feeling a river flowing out of my.
Your phone ready.
I'm feeling it.
Which country? Badara.
I'm feeling it.
Who can get the most phone calls in there? Let nothing steal your joy this morning, baby. It's all up to you. Life has always been up to you, baby. The choices we make in life, baby. Yeah. If you're born again, put on your whole armor. Everything. The socks, the shoes, the shield, the heart. Yeah. You're gonna need it. Yeah, man. Bible says many are called, few are chosen.
Come on, sing this. Out of my belly shall flow.
Not everybody want to go all the way. Don't let them hinder your growth. Keep your faith. You know who you are. Establish yourself in Christ. Which country,
brother?
My God, at the top of the hour, don't forget the phone number 347-663-8638. Call as much as you can. The phone will be very engaged. That's where you gotta exercise your patience. Kennedy, St. Lucia today. Jamaica, Barbados, Grenada, Panama, St. Lucia, Dominica, Trinidad, St. Vincent, V.I. Who didn't I call? Yes, you too. Haiti, Belize. My God. You gotta feel it yourself. Nani? Somebody clock already saying the time. Let's go. Are you ready? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from, Kola? Where you from? Where you from, Kola? Where you from, Kola? Where you from? Please turn on your radio. 347-663-8638. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Ooh, 347-663-8638. Please turn on your radio.
Yeah.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Kola?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Alright, 347-663-8638. I'm talking fast now. 347-663-8638. Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, yeah. 347-663-8638. Who bada? Tell me, Kola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Oh, yeah. 347-663-8638. Don't let nobody scare you. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Oh, yeah. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Grenada. Huh. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Oh, yeah. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Wow. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Oh, yeah. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My God. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color? All right. 347-663-8638. Keep the call. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
347-663-8638. Who badara? Who have the best phone in America? Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color?
San Vincent.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness. 347-663-8638. Who bada? Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
My goodness. My friend, you alright? Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness. Who's gonna do it today? Who's gonna do it? Who's gonna do it? Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, I tell you toe-to-toe. Don't let nobody frighten you. Call. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
My goodness. Who bada this morning? Who bada? Which country bada? 347-663-8638. The phone is busy. Keep calling. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color?
Barbados.
All right. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color?
Trinidad.
Alright. 347-663-8638. Turn down your radio. 347-663-8638. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
347-663-8638. Which country, bada? Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Russia.
347-663-8638. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
347-663-8638. Who got the baddest phone in America? Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Who gonna make it all the way? Who gonna do it all the way? That's the question. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color? Where you from, Color? All right, listen to your phone, not your radio, please. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Anyway.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Panama.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Wow. 347-663-8638. Who bada? Who have the fastest fingers in America? Who have the most patience? More you get busy, Tony's, more you call. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from,
Grenada?
Color? All right. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
I tell you, we have a tight race going on right now. It's very tight. Keep calling, even if the country don't call yet. Keep calling. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, 347-663-8638. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color?
Jamaica.
All right, turn on your radio. Tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Color?
St. Lucia.
All right, tell me, Color, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Oh, yeah. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Wow. 347-638-638. We have enough time to go still. 10 more minutes. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, anybody could win this one. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Huh. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Lucia.
Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, fella?
Jamaica.
All right. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Ooh, who bada? Who bada? Who bada? Which country bada? Huh. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Wait,
tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Oh, 347-663-8638. 347-663-8638. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Wait, tell me, fella, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Whoa. 9 more minutes. 347-663-8638. Which country badara? Who can get the most phone calls in? Who can take the most busy tone and still call back? Who have the most patience? Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, caller?
Jamaica.
All right. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
In Russia.
Boy. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, caller, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Wait, tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, who's gonna make it to the end? Hey, tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Carla? Where you from, Carla? Where you from?
Panama.
Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? All right. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
My God. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, we're going neck and neck this one. 347-663-8638. 8 more minutes to go. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Mm-hmm. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Mm-hmm. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Huh. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, I tell you, this one is something else this morning. 347-663-8638. Who badara? Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Grenada. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Oh, yeah. Who going down? Who going down this morning? Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from,
Jamaica.
Gola? All right. Tell me, Gola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Gola?
Trinidad.
Tell me, Gola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, I tell you, don't give up. Don't care what country you're from. Don't give up. Don't make nobody make you afraid to call. Tell me, Gola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Gola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Oi. Tell me, Gola, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Oi. Where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, I tell you, anybody could do this one this morning. Anybody? 5 more minutes to go. 5 more minutes. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Carla?
From Panama.
My goodness. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Who bada? Who badara? Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Carla?
Lucia.
All right, my friend. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Hey, tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Panama.
Huh. Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Ooh, that's a wicked one. Indeed. 5 more minutes to go. Who bada? Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Lucia.
What do you mean? Tell me, Carla, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Jamaica, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, I tell you, any country could win this one. We have enough time to go, you know, man. We have enough time. Jamaica, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
From Panama.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Hey, tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
My goodness, what a race this morning. What a race. What a race. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Colour?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? 4 more minutes.
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Colour? Where you from? 4 minutes.
Jamaica. Jamaica.
Jamaica. Jamaica. Jamaica. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
347-6638-638. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Colour? Where you from? I'm waiting. I'm waiting. Okay. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Alright, you gone. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Huh. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica, Jamaica.
Ooh, so big. She said twice. 347-6638-638. 3 more minutes to go. Which country gonna make it all the way to the top? Huh? Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
My goodness, I tell you, they come like wild ants now. 347-6638-638. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Who by the Colour?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
My goodness. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Brother Chris. 347-6638-638. Which country, Badara? 3 more minutes to go. Who can do it? Who gonna make it all the way to the top? Who gonna do it? I tell you, don't let nobody make you afraid, you know. Don't make nobody make you afraid this morning, you know. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad and Tobago.
What you mean? Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Boy, tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, I tell you, this is a serious what you call war. With a 2 hour. Tell me, Colour, where you from?
Panama.
My goodness. 347-6638-638. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Trinidad.
What do you mean? Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Saint Lucia.
Wait. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
What do you mean? Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
2 more minutes to go. 2 more minutes. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Wait. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Huh. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
I'm Panama.
Wait. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Oh my goodness, I tell you what, this is what you call a war. It's spelled with double A. Double RR. Yes, indeed. 2W. 2A. 2R. Who bother? 1 more minute. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Tell me,
Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Ooh, yeah. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
My goodness, I tell you, who's gonna make it all the way? All the way. 347-6638-638. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Grenada.
Yes. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from?
Jamaica.
Ooh, I tell you, this is what you call a war. 347-6638-638. Tell me, Colour, where you from? Where you from? Where you from, Colour?
Grenada.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm hey. Sure.
The horn, Colour, where you from this morning? How you doing today?
Grenada.
And what's so nice about Grenada? What's nice about Grenada? You got all right, you hang up. Colour, good morning. Where you from and what's nice about your country? You got Colour, good morning. Where you from and what's nice about your country this morning? Are you there?
Yes, Jamaica.
What is so nice about Jamaica this morning? What's nice about Jamaica?
Well, as you all know, it's a beautiful place.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful ground coffee, mountain tea coffee, beaches, landscape. Where the jerk chicken come from? And Jamaica, we deal with man and woman. Marriage is between one man and one woman. That's what we deal with.
All right.
Land of wood and water. Jamaica, land we love.
Land we love, indeed. Thank you, my sister, in Jesus'
name. Thank you very much.
Amen. Hey, Carla, where you from and what's nice about your country this morning? Where you from?
My country is about, it feels good in the beach, and the water is so sparkly. And I like the food and the hills, and it makes me feel happy.
And what country are we talking about?
Grenada.
Wow, indeed. All right. Thank you, young man.
Yeah.
Thank you, young lady. 16 minutes on the other side of the one.
Yeah.
It is Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. As we encourage you in Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Yes, Jesus. Get to know the Lord.
Wait on you for the outpouring of the Holy.
Don't care what the world is trying to tell you. This Jesus,
we watch for you.
He's real.
To you we tune our
and he wants you to enjoy an abundant life.
As we look.
Peace of mind.
Hearts in one accord.
Hallelujah.
And voice.
And we want to encourage you,
yeah,
that you will seek it and find it while you can.
Hearts with fire.
And let me say to all the believers, man, you gotta put on your new self. You gotta put on. You gotta put it on. You gotta activate your new body. If you say you're a new creature, you have to activate it. That's the way it works. If you don't activate it, it can't work. It won't work. You won't understand what we're talking about. So activate it, alright? Submit to God, resist the devil. Watch him running. I tell you what, I raised this morning, man. I tell you why now. I'm looking at this paper right here with this among the calls, and I don't know if it's Jamaica or Grenada or Panama. It's just a race
rain down
on a different level.
Spirit, right.
And I felt in my spirit that many other countries were intimidated by the early run, by the other countries that started off with so much pep and so much speed, running down the track, running, they got scared. And that is a trick of the enemy, man. I'm telling you, you could come from behind. You ever look at a horse racing? They have a horse running, chuka, 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 and in the end, they say home stretch, and that horse just come and pass everybody like it. They were never running. So that's the way it runs. You got to believe in your country, believe in yourself, believe in your contribution. This is something you have to believe by faith and believe and do it. Practically, you have to apply those things practically to your life. The things of God are by faith. Faith is a substance. You cannot see it, but by faith you believe it. So all applications for the Christian believer, that is where it lies. That's where it dwells. Hallelujah. That's what it is. So don't be intimidated if you start enough in the last 5 minutes. If you got faith enough, you can win. Coming from 5 minutes to go, you can rise up and start calling your country. And if you really believe, we can see miracles happen right here on Choice Radio in that area right there. Because God is a God that shows us all things. All things he shows us in all our life. We see God in all applications of life. And I could boast of that because God is a just God. He's a fear God. And if you're looking, you're going to see. If you're listening, you're going to hear this God we're talking about. So we're going to come back and tabulate. So go ahead and make your tabulations. Remember, the person with the correct tabulations with Choice Radio will receive a cake from Bruce's, 9509 Church Avenue. Or if your preference is Tasty Patty Baker and Grill, 3122 Church Avenue or 1431 Rockaway Parkway. Or opposite the Restoration Plaza on Fulton Street, they will give you a beautiful 8-inch cake. All right, to your liking now.
Choice Radio, here we go, here we go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Want inspiration? Want to be lifted and refreshed? You gotta turn your radio. Choice Radio. Choice Radio. This music brings heat.
joy and life to the deepest. Oh, gotta keep on.
Bruce's Patties, Bruce's Patties. It's all about the original Bruce's Patties and Baked Things, located at 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and East 96th Street in Brooklyn. Telephone 718-922-CAKE, that's 718-922-2253. All baking is done on premises. Are you longing to eat some real delicious patties? Check out the original Bruce's Patties and Baked Things. They have the best patties in Brooklyn. Oh my God, they have beef, chicken, veggie, salmon, fish, and of course, ackee patties right here in Brooklyn. Also, are you celebrating an event? Do you need a cake? The original Bruce's Patties have the best birthday cake in Brooklyn. Wedding cake, character cake, red velvet cake, and your photo cake. Ask about their pastries, their plantain tart, their currant rolls, the coconut drop, hollow bread, whole wheat bread, and their trini bread. That's the original Bruce's Patties and Baked Things. 9509 Church Avenue, between East 95th and East 96th Street in Brooklyn. Telephone 718-922-CAKE or 718-922-2253. Desmond is back.
Choice Radio has established a prayer line Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. The number is 718-715-4411. Please call for help, for prayer, and for counseling. If there's no one on the line, please leave a message. They'll get right back to you and offer prayer with you.
From Jamaica to you with love and with great taste, it's Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill for the most delicious food you've ever tasted. Try the curry goat. So mouth-watering, you must have more than one. Also the curry chicken, jerk chicken, stew cow foot. Try the escovitch fish, brown stew fish, and many other taste-good dishes. All served with rice and peas or white rice. And check out also the soup of the day. You want a patty? Try the Angus beef, Allen chicken, salmon fish, and veggie patties. You love all of them. Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill. Also has cakes, birthday cakes, fruit cakes, red velvet cakes, and photo cakes with your picture right on the cake. Sample their hard dough bread, Trini mongoose bread, sweet bread, and other delectable breads and rolls. Tasty also has Nick's Barbados bread, such as tennis rolls, lead pipe, and other favorites. And don't forget the jackass corn. Remember that? Yes, they have it. Jackass corn, a Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill. It's many islands, one people, one love. A Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill, the home of good taste, located at 3122 Church Avenue, 1431 Rockaway Parkway, and 1371 Fulton Street, all in Brooklyn.
Anua. Anua. Anua.
À présent, diable à bruit.
Anoua.
À présent, diable à bruit. Nous calons pile au nom de Jésus. Moi, j'ai crié tout le monde. Tout le monde en Jésus.
24 minutes on the other side. Of 1 o'clock, if you tabulated, it's your time to let us know what you've heard.
It's been a long
347-663-8638. Let us see if your numbers are lined up.
Me.
Inside the studio,
he wants to put you.
The people we recorded today was Grenada, Jamaica, St. Lucia, St. Vincent, Trinidad, Panama, Barbados, and Haiti. That's the name we heard.
Yeah. He's been defeated.
Many more might have tried,
but, you can turn him down.
But those are who we can say we heard.
Stop.
If you got the numbers right,
in the name of Jesus.
347-663-8638, those were definitely are veterans of this segment. If you tabulated, that is your opportunity to disclose what you have tabulated. Stamp Satan in the meantime.
Okay.
Let's go to the phone caller. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening.
Hi, my daughter just calling in with a tally.
Amen. Let's go.
Hello.
56, Grenada 56, Jamaica 52, Trinidad 4, St. Lucia 9, St. Vincent 1, Panama 23, and that's it.
And again, Barbados?
Barbados 1.
Uh-huh, you got Haiti?
No.
All right, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4. You got 4 correct. And the other numbers, you didn't miss them by much. Probably at much as 5. All right, so your numbers are not that bad. All right?
Okay.
Thank you, young lady.
Okay.
All right. Hey, caller, good afternoon.
Hello?
Hey.
Yes, greetings.
Greetings. Greetings in Jesus' name.
I got Haiti 1, Barbados 1, Panama 24, St. Lucia 9. St. Vincent 1, Jamaica 58, Trinidad 5, and Grenada 54.
Well, caller, you really, really up on it. I mean, right now, your numbers are really, 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 really good. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You got 6. You're missing the rest. But those you're missing, you're not by far. By 1 or 2 points from the real numbers.
Alright.
Yes. Hey, caller, good afternoon. That kick could be yours if you're paying attention.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we have Trinidad 5, Jamaica 59, Grenada 52, St. Lucia 9, St. Vincent 2, Panama 23, Barbados 1, Haiti 1.
Caller, let me say one thing to you. Are you listening on the air? Are you listening on the internet? Where are you listening from?
No, the radio.
My goodness, caller, you have a kind of ears that your ears is just... I never heard about 2020 air, but you can use 2020 for your ears. They're really, really good. Unfortunately, you have one. You're missing one by one, if you know what I mean. And when I say this, I mean this in the most oddest way. I mean it in a very odd fashion. When I'm saying you miss it by one, it's very odd. The way you miss it by one, it's really, really, really odd. As a matter of fact, every single caller who called before gave that country the exact right number. From even those who didn't know a lot, gave it the right number, but for some reason, you give it the wrong number. I don't know why. You miss it by one. One by one, if you know what I mean. You're missing one country by one point. Whichever that one is, I don't know. You call me back.
Okay.
What a tabulation. Wow, I was shaking already. I thought, wow. She took all the fun out of the story today. She missed one country by one point. Which is that country? I think people are ready to get it right here now. Caller, good morning. All right, you there? That caller changed her mind. All right, caller, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Double O.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm good. Okay.
Caller, let me see if you were paying attention to that previous caller. She only got one country wrong by one point, and it's a over point, if you understand. The one she got wrong, out of everyone, she gave it a over point, if you understand what I'm saying.
Why you have to be like this?
Hallelujah. Tell me, caller.
Okay, Jamaica 59. Trinidad 5, St. Vincent 1, Grenada 52, St. Lucia 9, Panama 23, Barbados 1, and 81.
Hello, are you there? Hello? Hello?
Yes.
Are you there?
I'm here.
Is your phone working? Hello? Hello? Somebody scream! That is a scream. That is a real scream. We could sell that.
Oh God!
Carla, what gave it away for you? What gave it away?
Excuse me, I didn't hear you.
What gave it away for you? What make you get it?
You told me, you said to her that she go over by one and everybody else get that one, and that's the only one.
And which one was it? St. Vincent, right?
St. Vincent!
Oh my goodness. Congratulations to you, my caller, indeed. All right? Hold
thank
the phone.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Hold the phone. Thank you. Hold the phone. Thank okay. you too. Amen.
Anoua. A présent, diable a pris. Nous allons piler dans de Jésus. Moi, je crie tout le monde. Tout le monde en Jésus. Filez avec moi.
It's been a long time. The devil's been attacking you. Oh yes, oh yes. Hardship and misery. He wants to put you through. But through the blood of Jesus Christ, we got the power to overcome. Yeah, yeah. He's been defeated. So if you can chant him down, are you with me? Stamp, we say stamp, Satan. In the name of Jesus, stand up, Mrs. Stamp, say.
All right, Miss Latoya Oakley again.
Stand up, Mrs.
A big win on Choice Radio.
In the name of Jesus.
So, okay, we go ahead and give congratulations to Jamaica. Really, really going at it. I don't know what Jamaicans heard this morning, but they say, my goodness, we ain't going to take it like that. We ain't going to take it lying down. And this Jamaican came out with fire, 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 fire from the start to the end. 59 points for Jamaica, followed by a strong run from Grenada. Strong. When I tell you strong, they really put it on. They put it on, but I think they thought they had it in the bag already. They kind of slowed down a little bit. So definitely 59 points for Jamaica in the first position. Second position, a strong run, very strong run, convincingly by Grenada with 52 points, followed by Panama. Panama was really, really, really strong. Really, I mean, just let's give Panama some respect this morning. Panama was going at it all or nothing. They were really going at it. We got something sporadically in there from St. Lucia in between there, which up to 9 points. Trinidad sung very like they were not sure if they really wanted to participate today for whatever reason. They got 5 points. They sound like, well, we already lost. Oh, we can't make it. We, oh, what are we going to do? Oh, my God. Let me just call and say Trinidad. You know, that was not the real spirit of Trinbago. I didn't really hear the Trinbago spirit. That's what I just get in my, you know, that's what I got, you know what I mean? And St. Vincent was kind of in between there when I made a little prompting and say, don't let nobody stop you. Probably one person got through and say, St. Vincent, when he's dead, you know, somebody came from Barbados, you know, Billy, you know, Haiti, you know, really. But I'm saying, overall, we thank everybody who participated. We thank all those who listened. And like I said, man, it's just an exercise, you know. We home and we just an exercise, you know. We love our country, we love where we're from, and we just call and acknowledge where we are. I'm from there, and you know, it's just to give us a little exercise and being patriotic, acknowledging where we are from, and you know. So it's just that's a little exercise that we do, and also testing our patience. Cause when you call the phone is busy, and you know, please leave them whatever, and then you have to call again. So it takes us to a place where we can submit and have patience and call back and develop our patience, because patience is something that we really need. I need a lot of patience myself, because the devil gonna try to tempt us in all kinds of ways for us to transgress against God and the leading of the Holy Spirit. So we have to try our patience and build it up that we are able to just do what is right in the eyes of God. And what is in my heart so strong to say to you out there in Radio Land this morning is that, look, we as believers in Christ have to take a stand to say that I am not going to allow the devil to make me just keep going like just going and going and going. It's like you tell one lie and you don't know how to recover from that one little lie, and you have to go to another lie and another lie and another lie, when you can just look people in the eye and just say it as it is and let it be. Whatever happened, let the chips fall where they may. And this is what God looking for us to do as believers, to really exercise our strength in being who we are in Christ, being strong. And it's in my spirit that, like, it's like, you know, sometimes people, you know, they feel that they expect something from you, or you expect something from them, and you don't get it. So then they don't know how to face you because you didn't live up to something. And they are putting themselves in a bad position. This is just in my spirit, because I'm feeling in my spirit like there are people who, like, oh, they listen to Joyce Radio and, like, we had a boat ride and probably didn't come and probably they thought that we were expecting to see that particular individual and we didn't see them. So then they feel bad when they didn't come. So now they avoiding to call or they avoiding. And this is in my spirit. If I'm speaking in my spirit to somebody out there who are feeling that we are holding that kind of reservation over you, that you are feeling embarrassed because you didn't live up to an expectation, let me tell you something. God wants us to live free. Free as birds in the sky. And let no man put you in a place where you feel like you're bonded. Jesus died to set us free. Free from all kind of condemnation. From anyone. From any association of anyone who might want to make you feel less. So my brother and sister, if you're out there in Radio Land and you feel for some reason that, well, oh, well, somebody look out for me somewhere or whatever and I didn't live up to it and I don't know how to face them, just face the world with the love of Jesus. Be honest. Just be open. Be honest. Live your life free in the freedom and liberty to which Christ has set you free. Read Galatians 5:1. Stand fast in the liberty to which Christ had set you free. Set yourself free, brothers and sisters. Resist the devil in every application. Do not even tell the smallest lie as a Christian. Don't tell not even the smallest lie. Just stop. Cease and desist. Be a child of God. Strive to do all that is right in the eyes of the Lord. And He is going to vindicate you. He is going to give you that liberty that you're not afraid to walk among nobody. Don't care how much money you have. Don't care how you dress. You will be strong in the power and the might of God. And this is what God wants us to walk in, that liberty that we know who we are in Christ. And we are not doing nothing to live up to the world standard and what the world expects of us. No! We're going to stand fast in the liberty to which Christ has set us free. So whatever is bonding you this morning, today, and making you feel that you cannot come out, you cannot reach out, you cannot be apart, come on, stand up against the devil and tell him you're a liar. Because if you make me lie one time, I have to lie another time to cover up that lie and cover up another one and another one. When will it end? End it today. End it today. Come clean with yourself and let God set you free in the liberty. Because there is victory in Jesus when you stand on the word of God and you stand fast. Because God is only able to do for you what you want done when you acknowledge where you are. And you acknowledge the situation for what it is. God is able to bring you out or take you to another level. But if you keep lying and you don't want to admit and you're allowing the devil to put you in a place where you cannot feel free to bask in the glory of God, then you are deceiving your own self. So brothers and sisters, I'm saying this to you. The Christian life is an active life. It's not passive. It's not something you just say, you save and you say whatever, and you don't do nothing in the practical realm. You have to do things in the physical realm to validate your spiritual walk with God. So I'm encouraging you as a believer, strive to do it. Resist the devil in all applications. Don't care where he tried to trick you. Say, no, God don't want me to do that. I don't care what you tell me. That is the truth. I'm telling you as it is. I'm not trying to present nothing to nobody to make it look good to them. And then I'm suffering in my Christian walk. Stand fast in the liberty to which Christ has set you free. And set your soul free that God can flow through you. And you can be a viable part of this great salvation. That is when you're going to see God working. My brother and sister, let me tell you something, you know. What I have noticed, the things that look so hard to achieve in the world, to Christ, it's a breeze. The devil going to make you feel, man, you could never tell these people that. How they going to look at you? Come on, you could never say that. You could never talk like that. You could never just tell them the truth about the situation. No! You got to give them a little story. You must make a little thing. You got to make it look good. Come on. Remember, you're in America. What you going to do? You can't make it look like you don't have no money. You can't make it look that you're broke. You can't make it look like you don't have, own a house. You can't make it look like nothing. That's what the devil wants you to do. That's what the devil wants you to do. The devil wants you to do that. The devil wants you to live in sin as much as he can so you would not see the full manifestation of God in your life. And you have to make up your mind to say, me, I'm out of this now, so God can do what he has to do in our life. It's like you have a garage with an old car in there and you want a new car. Well, where are you going to put the new car if there is an old car in the garage? It's the same way. He wants you to keep living in sin. If you're unmarried and you know the word and you keep living and you feel, well, how are I going to make it because this man is going to leave me or whatever? How are I going to survive? That's what he wants. He wants to keep you right there so you don't acknowledge God. And then God will not be able to function because you are not giving him that flow where he can flow. It's up to you. As a believer in Christ, you have to be willing to do all that you can see before you that is not right with God. Strive to do all that is right. If there are things that in your life that you're not aware of it, well, we understand if you're not aware of something. So you don't know what you have to do. But if you are aware of something that is wrong in the sight of God, and God is keep telling you through all different kind of people, he's trying to show you, I need you to come up a little higher. I want you to come to meet me. I want you to trust me. And you're not deciding to trust God, you will never see the full manifestation of the love of this God that we're talking about. He's willing, he's able, but you have to do your part so he can do his part. This is just so strong and overwhelming in my spirit. If it's for anybody out there, take it, go with it, because God is talking to you this morning. Glory to the name of Jesus. So it's 141 on Choice Radio. And you know, let me say this, brethren, as a believer, I'm a new believer in Christ, and I've just started walking with the Lord recently. And I have encountered so much things in my short walk with the Lord that I tell you, if you're not strong, trust me. You know, if you don't understand the warfare that is waging, you're going to probably just give up. And I could understand how believers give up. Because it's so much deception and so much discouragement that you will find in the Christian walk from people that you look up to who already supposed to have it done back. And supposed to be an example by the talk and by what it is that they claim. You will be shocked. But you see what happened? This is my validation. That yes, my brother, you're in the right thing. You're in the right. We are in the truth. Because nothing good come easy. Cheap things are not good. And good things are not cheap. And this is the validation that the Christian walk is worthwhile walking for Jesus. It is worthwhile to walk. So I want to encourage you in Christ. Stay strong. Stay in the Lord. Stay in the name of Jesus. Stay. Strive. Put on the whole armor. You say you change? Change. Act like you change. Act like you change. Try to start acting like a changed person. Because that's the only way the new man will able to take its rightful place in our lives. All right, so I hope this has been some kind of encouragement. Father, I did it. I said it. Yes, okay, I said it. Yes, I said what I had to say in the name of Jesus. And all this is just in love, you know. It's not to condemn anyone. It's not to put down anyone. It's not directed or designated to any particular person that we know or we come in touch with. No, nothing like that. Nothing is, you know, directed to anybody. It's to all of us. We just want to see what the Spirit wants us to reveal, that we can go ahead and we can be all strengthened in our walk with God. So the next step, what we're going to do on Choice Radio, we're going to just play some music, play some requested songs. That's what the Lord lay on my spirit. You know, before we saw a little praying for people and different things. And, you know, every ministry is different. You know what I mean? And I just want to function the way the Lord wants us to function and lead on our spirit, that we're just going to go with the flow. Who God sent to us, we're going to use them. We're going to work with them as the time allotted and the season change and different things happen. We're going to just go with the Lord and allow the Lord to lead us on Choice Radio that will able to do his will. So the next segment will be taking requests. If you have a song that you want me to play for you that is going to light up your life this evening, that's going to, you know, just enhance your spiritual walk, that's going to strengthen you, that's going to make you get up and continue to walk for the Lord, feel free to call me if I could find it online. If you know the singer, you know the name of the title of the song or whatever, We encourage you to call and give us your information. All calls will be taken off the air. So go ahead and you can call and give us a song request that you want us to play for you as we just bask in the Lord's presence right here on Choice Radio. Keep it locked, indeed.
Choice Radio, here we go, here we go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Want inspiration? Want to be lifted and refreshed? You got to turn your radio.
Choice Radio, Choice Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on.
Choice Radio is a blessing and an inspiration to you. Write us at Choice Gospel Network, P.O. Box 30016, Brooklyn, New York, 11203.
Nothing can separate, even if I ran away, 'cause your love never fails.
Ladies and shoppers, get the world's best brands and the highest quality at lowest prices. Always use Dr. Robert's brand natural patent barley and Dr. Robert's energy glucose, real Jamaican brand oats, teas, and a wide variety of products. Lassie Oats, build up nourishment and Magnum supplemented energy malted hot chocolate bar powder now on sale. Real Guyana brand whole wheat chow mein full of whole wheat fibers. Real Guyana brand regular chow mein recipe print at the back of the bag. Now on sale and at deep discount prices are Tip Top brand Circle Cheese, Anchor brand New Zealand Cheddar Cheese, Cow and Girl brand Wanpong Wretch Dutch Baby Edam and Baby Gouda Cheese with low salt and no sugar, Dan Cow brand, Greenland brand and Red Cow brand evaporated milk and milk powder. Get Breakaway brand vegetable whole wheat crackers and vegetable regular crackers, Breakaway big packet coffee and tea cookies, Breakaway England's best tastiest milk chocolate caramel direct from England, Breakaway supplement malted milk cookies with energy vitamins. They are so tasty and delicious you can eat them bare with coffee, tea or any beverage. Get fast relief from pain. Use Dr. Robert's Atermogene brand muscles, flu, waist, arthritis and strong pain rub. Get more power, more energy when you drink Real Power brand energy and stamina drink. Now on sale at a special price of only $1.99 for a 12-ounce bottle. Enjoy Breakaway brand natural Irish 6-cup dessert fruit pudding. It's very delicious and it aids and nourishes all your joints, knees and cartilages. Get Champion brand flour, the best whole wheat flour and all-purpose baking flour, imported from Canada. Remember to get your England best chocolate caramel, the best tasting chocolate caramel bar from England. On sale at most discount stores, supermarkets, 99-cent stores and food stores. Or also from wholesale through AFN brokers. 908-486-0077 or INP Foods at 25 Brooklyn Terminal Market.
Radio has established a prayer line Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. The number is 718-715-4411. Please call for help, for prayer, and for counseling. If there's no one on the line, please leave a message. They'll get right back to you and offer prayer with you. Please call Choice Radio 718-715-4411. Choice Radio Network.
Oh, there was a woman in the Bible days. She had been.
And the first request going out to the man, Brother Lewin, touched the hem of his garment by Sam Cooke.
Oh, there was
347-663-8638. If you need a request, go ahead. All calls taken off the air.
Oh, there was a woman in the Bible days. She had been sick, sick so very long. But she heard my Jesus was passing by, so she joined the gathering throng. And while she was pushing her way through, someone asked her, "What are you trying to do?" She said, "If I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole." She cried, "Oh, Lord, and oh, Lord." Until she had no more to spare. The doctors, they done all they could, but their medicine would do no good. When she touched him, the Savior didn't see, but still he turned around and cried, "Somebody touch me." She said, "It was I who just wanna touch the hem of your garment. I know I'll be made whole right now." She stood there crying, "Oh, oh, 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 and oh, oh, Lord, and oh, Lord." Said, "If I could just touch."
One more time from Dan Cook, indeed. Brother Lewin, 8 more minutes before the hour, 2 o'clock. Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice.
In the Bible days,
you found the peace of the Lord. You'll be able to enjoy this kind of vibration.
Oh, there was a woman in the Bible days. She had been sick, sick so very long. But she heard my Jesus was passing by, so she joined the gathering throng. And while she was pushing her way through, someone asked her, "What are you trying to do?" She said, "If I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole." She cried, "Oh, Lord, and oh, Lord, and oh, Lord, and oh, Lord." Said, "If I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole." And whoa, she spent her money here and there until she had no more to spare. The doctors, they done all they could, but their medicine would do no good. When she touched him, the Savior didn't see, but still he turned around and cried, "Somebody touch me." She said, "It was I who just wanna touch the hem of your garment. I know I'll be made whole right now." She stood there crying, "Oh, oh, 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 and oh, oh, Lord, and oh, Lord." Said, "If I could just touch the hem of your garment, I know I'll be made whole right now."
Reaching out to Monique and Hollis. Give myself away.
So you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away. So you can. Come on, let him know. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away.
What would happen if the generation embraced this? Come on, tell them.
Here I am. Here I am. I stand, Lord, my life is in your hand. Lord, I long you to see your desires revealed in me. I give myself away.
By you.
So you can use me. I give myself away. So you.
So God, take my heart.
Everybody, let's give God this worship. If you know he's awesome, come on, stand on your feet, everybody. If you know he's awesome, you're in awe of his grace. You're in awe of his goodness. You're in awe of his mercy. You're in awe of his provision. He's great and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift your hands. as we lift our voices. Come on, say, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say, he can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Come on, say it. Hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
That's it. My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on. Heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened.
Where I've been weakened.
Forever he'll reign. Come on, you got it. My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say, he can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the
Hide
rain.
From
Has he ever covered
rain.
You? Come on, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened.
Where I've been weakened.
Forever he'll reign.
Forever.
One word, come on everybody.
My God is awesome.
This is going out to Anthony coming from his loving wife Cheryl.
Come on everybody, let's give God this worship. If you know he's awesome, come on, stand on your feet everybody. If you know he's awesome, you're in awe of his grace, you're in awe of his goodness, you're in awe of his mercy, you're in awe of his provision. He's great and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Come on everybody, lift your hands as we lift our voices. Come on, say, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say, he can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Come on, say it, hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
That's it. My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on. Heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened.
Strength where I've been weakened.
Forever he'll reign.
Forever he will reign.
Come on, you got it. My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say, he can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the
Hide
rain.
From
Has he ever covered
rain.
You? Come on, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Heals me when I'm broken.
He'll see when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened.
Where I've been weakened.
Forever he'll reign.
Forever
One word.
Reign.
Come on, everybody.
My God is awesome.
Come on, somebody lift your voice.
Awesome.
If you know he's been good, say it.
Awesome.
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 Say, my God. If you know he's been good to you, testify.
Awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice.
Awesome.
He's awesome.
Awesome.
Come on. My God.
My God.
Verse 2.
Savior
of the whole world.
Savior of the whole.
Giver of salvation.
Giver of salvation.
By his stripes.
By his stripes
I'm healed. Yeah. My God is awesome.
My God.
Listen, today I am forgiven.
Today I am forgiven.
His grace is why
grace
I'm living.
Is why I'm
Somebody ought to praise his holy name.
Holy name.
Come on, you say, my God.
My God is awesome.
Come on, awesome.
Awesome.
3 minutes past the 2 o'clock.
Awesome.
You requested we play it for you.
Awesome.
347-663-8638. All calls taken off the air.
For your life.
347-663-8638.
The Lord has brought you from.
Awesome.
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 Let's talk about why he's awesome. You said,
he's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
Awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice and celebrate.
Awesome.
If you know he's been good, you said,
he's holy.
He's holy,
he's holy,
he's holy,
he's holy,
awesome.
Awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice and testify.
Awesome.
If you know he's been good, you say,
he's great,
he's great,
he's great,
he's great,
he's great,
he's great,
awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice and testify.
Awesome.
If you know he's been good, you say,
he's great.
valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
Oh, my God is.
My God is awesome.
Heals me when I'm
broken. Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been
weak.
Praise His holy
praise
name.
Praise His holy name.
Oh, somebody ought to celebrate the awesome name.
This I'm gonna tell me, Cheryl. Take me to the king. Don't forget it's your request and dedication. You name it, we play it. You request it, we play it for you. As we lift up the name of Jesus this afternoon on Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. If it's the first time you're listening, we're all about Jesus on Choice Radio. Thank you, Jesus.
Truth is, I'm tired. Options are few. I'm trying to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't fake what's left. Truth is, I'm weak. No strength to fight. No tears to cry. Even if I tried. But still, my soul refuses to die. Mm-hmm. One touch will change. Take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe.